glad you're joining us tonight. As we put together this special program in a partnership between Steinway Hall Plano and the Dallas Jazz Piano Society. The program is sponsored by both Steinway Hall Plano and the Friends of Jim Calloway. Features two of our favorite pianists, Stephen Harlos, who performed twice on our concert series that just finished up, and Kent Ellingson, who's going to be on our Piano Madness concert coming up in May of next year. Our program starts up for the 2021-22 season, September 21st, with Quentin Gray performing the music of Chick Corea. You may hear a Chick Corea song by these two tonight. So I'm going to turn it over to Stephen and Kent for the program. Thank you.
Thank you. So good evening, everyone. That first tune was In a Mist by Bix Beiderbecke, and now we're going to go to the decade of the 1930s. So the tune that Steve and I have chosen for this decade is Beimir Bist du Schön. And this was composed in 1932 by Jacob Jacobs and Shalom Secunda. And this was for a Yiddish language-based musical comedy that lasted in Brooklyn, New York for only 1 year. However, there was one tune from this production, and the tune we're going to play for you now, that made it as a big hit in 1938 with the Andrews Sisters. So I hope you enjoy Beimir Bist du Schön.
Moving on to the 1940s with a great song from movie New Orleans. Composer Lou Alter wrote symphonies and all sorts of music, but he also was a great ragtime pianist and gave us some wonderful rags. But he also wrote this tune, and it was sung in the movie by Billie Holiday and with Louis Armstrong on the trumpet. And it was recorded since then by none other than Eddie Condon, Harry James, Ricky Nelson, and of course, Harry Connick Jr. And it's a standard in the jazz repertoire we're gonna do for you right now.
Selection for the 50s is going to be If I Were a Bell. Okay, so this of course was from the 1950 musical Guys and Dolls, but of course this was made into a jazz standard probably when Miles Davis recorded this in about 1956, I think. on his album Relaxing. And it's been a jazz standard ever since, and we'd like to do it for you now. If I Were a Bell.
Our next stop is 1967. And let's see. I was, I won't say how old. But I remember this tune on the radio. And somehow I associate it with summertime. It's one of those summer songs that was very popular. And we're talking about the Turtles and Happy Together. And for this concert, Kent has produced a wonderful jazz version, which has a few surprises in store. So we're going to do Happy Together. Thank you.
So perhaps you heard, or we played a little snippet of La Fiesta in that last tune, Happy Together. So that leads us into the decade of the 70s and Chick Corea, because now we're going to play for you the tune Spain. This was originally recorded in the early 1970s, and it was featured on the album Light as a Feather with Return to Forever. A lot of folks think that this is his most popular tune, and certainly has become a jazz standard. So we play for you now Chick Corea's Spain.
Thank you.
The next piece on our program, now we're out of the 70s into the 80s, and who remembers Bruce Hornsby from the 80s? That's one of the big super stars, great piano player and composer, singer, and he had a huge success with the song we're going to do, That's the Way It Is, just the way it is. And there's an interesting story behind it. I'll just tell you that the song was discovered by Huey Lewis, and apparently there was a golf match, and that was a bet, and he said, if I win, then you listen to my demo. And so I guess he won, and the rest is history. And this is, we're going to feature Kent in this tune, not only on the piano, but also vocal. And because the lyrics are very poignant and fitting. And so we're going to do That's Just the Way It Is.
That's just the way it is. All right, everyone, the next song that we are going to give to you will be our song choice for the 1990s. This is called Earth's Song by Michael Jackson. Personally, it's one of my favorite all-time pop ballads. This was released in 1995. And of course, Michael Jackson had a long history of releasing socially conscious material, and Earth's Song is the first pop tune that overtly dealt with the environment and also animal welfare. So let's take it away, Steve, with Earth's Song.
Thank you.
Okay, so going from the 90s to the 2000s, and the piece that was picked for this decade, I guess, for no other way to say it, is mine. This is an original composition that I wrote called Say No More. There's a little bit of cheating that goes on in this decade because I actually originally finished this back in 1989 at a jazz graduation class at University of North Texas with Dan Hurley. But I kind of rewrote it a little bit in the 2000s, and I think it was the 2000s that I actually performed it for the first time ever publicly. So anyway, hope you enjoy my composition, Say No More. Thank you.
that brings us to 2020. And we all know what happened in 2020. Actually, I think for a lot of artists, it was a time of creative outpouring. And this is a tune I wrote in 2020. And it's called Song of the Heart. And I hope that it's a affirmation of the endurance of love and the human spirit. And this will be the last tune on our program. And we thank you for watching and listening and supporting Dallas Jazz Piano Society. Thank you.
see you again real soon. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Ken. Thank you, Steve.
Thank you, Ken.